Coming up, we take a look at Office for Mac, including the latest updates from tailored features for the Mac, such as touch bar integration, new capabilities to support teamwork and real-time co-authoring with integrated chat, to intelligent experiences for content creation. If you're an IT admin, we're going to show you how advanced threat protection and conditional access also now extend to the Mac. By Scott from the Office for Mac team. Welcome.
Thanks so much for having me. Great to be on the show today.
So a lot of times when we open these shows, we see a Mac on the stage and people comment maybe in YouTube or other places that it's odd given our history with Windows.
Yeah, it's pretty funny to me because it's actually a little known fact. Microsoft's one of the largest developers for the Apple platform, really have been for decades now. We've got a whole dedicated lab, dedicated team. It spans across the entire globe and one of the largest Apple device labs right here on the Redmond campus.
Right. In fact, the work that we do on Mac actually goes beyond just Office. Our dev tools like Visual Studio Code run on Macs. Even our Quantum development kit is now actually available on the Mac as well.
And beyond the Mac, we of course support iOS, Android, and basically anywhere you want to be, we are too. So for Office, what really makes this possible is our core Office architecture, having a shared code base across Windows, Mac, and all those other platforms. And what this means is we can deliver new features for Office faster than ever before across all different platforms. The next thing you need to do is to think about creating the code base that's platform specific, integrating with the characteristics of the OS really down to that platform layer. And then on top of that, we want to build in a tailored user interface that complements the familiar Office feeling with that great opportunity of what the OS provides to us so it's natural and intuitive for the user base. And then the last step is we really want to bring that shared service code to hook into the different cloud services and intelligent capabilities such as AI.
So why don't we get specific on how we actually take advantage of the Mac OS and what we do in terms of offering tailored experiences for this platform.
Totally. So one of those Mac-specific features is the touch bar, and I want to go ahead and show you that today. So here in PowerPoint, we're going to go ahead and just click into Start. And as we go from slide to slide, you can actually see a nice, easy, cinematic kind of transition here. All this is powered with Morph. So let me go ahead and show you how you can do that with nothing but the touch bar and a few simple keyboard commands. So I'm going to go ahead and just copy the whole slide, grab onto this quadcopter up here, and then right on the touch bar, I can select it to rotate it to any angle I want. And it looks like 20 degrees or so is a great angle for us. I'm gonna move it over, resize this guy a bit, find a spot for it that looks great. And then up in transitions, I'm gonna go ahead and make sure Morph is turned on, and it looks like we're good to go. And now we'll dive into the slideshow to see what that looks like together. And as we go through the slides, we'll see this quadcopter hopping from the right side over to the left side with a nice, easy transition to create that rich cinematic feel. And it was super easy to get that done with just the keyboard itself and that touch bar, which is unique, of course, to the Mac platform.
Right, and this looks really great. One of my favorite features in terms of touch bar support is how it works with Word.
Definitely. So here we've got Word opened up, and I want to go ahead and show you something that's unique to the platform we have now with Word on Mac. We can go ahead and click into our focus mode. And the first thing you'll notice is it zooms right into that document, fading to black in the background and getting everything out of your way.
So you can focus on your work.
That's exactly right. And you notice even the ribbon has gone on top, but with the unique touch bar, we can still do some light editing right here in the document. For example, on top, I can go ahead and actually pick out our highlighter. I'm gonna go ahead and select the green color here. And now I can use the touchpad to just grab this whole paragraph, make it green, make it feel real important and easy to go. Another cool capability as well for light editing, I'll select in on the font. I can pick a new color out. I'm gonna go ahead and pick out this nice bright red, and then I can see where I wanna change the color scheme. And it looks like this area here would be a great candidate to all of a sudden be in our red ink. And we can do that nice, easy light editing from the touch bar. And if we swipe left to right, we can actually find several more opportunities, whether it's commenting or adding pictures, all there in focus mode.
Right, and these swipe gestures are something that also that we've taken from kind of the iOS roots in terms of how we're supporting Mac OS in this case. We can do some things with gestures in Outlook that we've taken from the mobile app.
Yeah, so right here in Outlook, as I scroll through my inbox, really similar, of course, to the iOS platform, now we can actually go ahead, find an email, and right on the trackpad, just swipe right to flag it, or I can swipe left to archive it. So real nice, easy gestures that are familiar from the phone are now here right on the Mac platform in our Outlook for desktop.
Really cool. And these are a couple of things that are specific to and unique to the Mac, but You mentioned that we hooked into things like cloud services, and we can also do the stuff that we'd expect on Windows or mobile devices right here from our Mac.
Yeah. So I'm going to go into Word and just open up a file here and show you some great examples of what the services can do for us. So as I open up in the backstage, you can notice that there is the shared with me area so that anything people have sent me over the past, you know, few weeks, few months is ready to go. And in my recent folder here, I can actually find everything that I've been working on most recently, of course. And it really helps us to avoid that idea of hunting around in the inbox for links to save us a ton of time. So I'm going to go ahead and just open up this quadcopter camera document that we've been working on here together the past week or so. And one of the really cool things you'll notice on the top right is it actually tells me you're in the document already working with me now.
I am.
And if I click onto this here, I can actually go ahead and find your location.
Okay.
Oh, and it looks like you're already actually in there typing in real time. It's super cool how it calls out for us your name directly, and you can follow that flag to see what you're working on.
And the nice thing is here with co-authoring, the documents automatically save it in the background so we don't lose any changes.
Yeah, plus you can use version history to revert to a version if you aren't happy with the current edits you're seeing. So that's just also up here in the top right. You see all the earlier versions of those files going on. But another cool capability to help us working together is we can actually chat with each other right in the document. So I see here in my chat window, there's two participants. I can say hey to you. It looks like Jeremy's particularly complimentary today, which I really appreciate.
Yes, I always am.
Makes it fun to work together. So just like that, we can stay in the document, chat with each other, and get what we need done real fast and easy.
So these are really great collaborative capabilities, and there are other things that you can do with AI to make it easier to work with teams that might be in other geographies as well.
Right. So let's say, for example, that you're actually working with a team over in Germany. With our integrated translator, we can go ahead and either create a selection of this document for translation or an entire document translation. So I'm going to pick out a little area here, go into our translate, pick a selection out. And one of the really cool things is it's actually going to auto-detect for us that it started in English and take us over into German. And we've got this panel in here before we insert anything to give us a sense of does it look right, feel right before we insert it.
And it looks pretty accurate. I actually even restructured the sentence a bit for German there. So it looks great. I'm a German speaker myself. Why don't we continue and translate the entire document?
Yeah, super helpful. So I'm going to go ahead now and actually translate this entire document. Again, it'll auto-detect that we're in English. So one of the really cool things is it's actually creating an entire second document. So we can grab it and go side by side with the German version that's brand new and the English version here on the left. And we can see, does it look right and feel right, and do a simple side-by-side comparison of those two docs and keep them separate.
This is another great use of intelligence, in this case cognitive services, to do translation of the document into a foreign language.
Yeah, and there's another way that we're using AI, and that's inside of Word with our resume assistant. So let me open up my recent resume. And with my recent resume open, I'm going to go over to our review tab and just turn on that resume assistant, which is all powered by LinkedIn. So I can go ahead in here and actually pick out whatever role I want to work on, which is really helpful as I think through of the different examples to get information and inspiration of how I might want to represent myself. And a cool aspect is I can even filter by different example, like product development here, and you see it start to get highlighted in those different representations. And a really cool thing too, as I build out my resume, I can actually pick out wherever I might want to work. And now that we've been talking about Germany so much, I've got Berlin on the mind. So let's take a look and see what opportunities are available there. And so now that we've got Berlin picked up, it's actually showing us local opportunities of where we could work. And if my resume is ready to go, a really cool benefit is I can turn on this option of being an open candidate and let recruiters know that I'm really open for business and I've got a great resume ready to land that dream job for me.
So great capabilities to help you find your next opportunity, but why don't we go back into PowerPoint to see how we're infusing intelligence in there?
Yeah, so I'm just going to open up a basic presentation and show you some of the cool capabilities we have going on now. We've got a really simple document here, but with AI and our designer tech, we can actually make this look great in just a few clicks. The first thing I want to do is go ahead and actually insert some pictures from my file here. I'm going to grab them, and this is part of that same quadcopter we were working on a moment ago. And as we drop in the images, on our right-hand side, AI-powered recommendations will pop in, pulling in the right color scheme, as well as if we pick a choice here, you'll even see it's cropping to the right part of that image so you don't lose at all the message you're trying to communicate with that visual. And it's not just about pictures. You can actually go ahead and get generated ideas for different paragraphs and different bullets. And again, it keeps that same color formula going. We'll grab one in here. And another really nice benefit is if you lay out a whole timeline in bullet form, we can convert that for you to a great visual, which makes it way easier for you to follow along with your audience. And then the last trick up our sleeve here in the designer world is with these set of bullets, you can also go ahead and pull out and create smart art based on keywords that are in that little sentence. So here you're seeing the action words are actually pulled out from the sentence. So you see download, join, share, talk. And in just a matter of a few clicks, we were able to create an awesome looking presentation that started so simple. And now it'll be more engaging, I hope, for the audience.
Right, that's going to save a lot of time as you're creating new slides. So the intelligence actually goes beyond just saving time and in the content and creation side of things. It also can be used to apply proactive security controls or information protection.
Yeah, that's a good point. So let's take a look at that here in Excel. Now, as I open my document up, it looks like things are all blacked out, and it might be a bit of a phishing scam happening here to grab some of my credentials and hurt my organization. So as we pull it up here, it actually gets protected through our safe link technology, and the intelligent security features grabbed it and said, hey, this looks a little bit malicious. You might not want to mess around with this website. So it stops me before anything goes wrong and helps me out.
So that's really part of advanced threat protection in Office 365, and that's what's in effect here, shielding you. Now, additional management controls also apply to the Mac that you might be making for Windows or for Mac, or in other cases, for mobile devices, things like data loss prevention. We also recently announced a partnership with Jamf, and this allows you to enforce conditional access policies on the Mac. And the way that works is it allows us to use their assessment of system health, whether or not the system's up to date and patched. Mm-hmm. And that information is then passed into Microsoft Intune and Azure Active Directory to enforce conditional access policies. Now, we recently also showed information classification in the Azure Information Protection tools that also work on the Mac, and you can check that out on a previous show. So that's really a great update in terms of the latest things that we've done for Office on the Mac. Thanks for joining us today, Scott, and covering all the great updates.
You know, we covered a lot of ground today, starting with that shared code base for the Office platform so you can deliver features faster than ever, taking a look at those Mac-specific benefits on the touch bar, and talking about how AI can really help you to be more productive. So the best way to get everything we talked about today, it's really with Office 365. That's our always up-to-date subscription. And if you want to learn more, just head on over to office.com and everything you need is right there to get started.
And of course, stay up to date with the latest news at Microsoft. Keep watching Microsoft Mechanics, subscribe to our channels, and follow us on Twitter. That's all the time we have for today's show. Thanks for watching, we'll see you next time.